Dan and Cedarburg represents the common bond between all the Northwest Coast tribes because we all use Cedarburg in our process of making rope and clothes, which was basically a survival method that we all used on the West Coast here. And then we have our universal symbol of wealth on the West Coast. I guess you could compare it to our a dollar sign. And then again, we have the CCU, which represents both good and bad. It's like our yin and yang. And then we have our sitting down figure, which represents a challenge to the individual to get up and do something about all our problems. It also represents the inaction of politicians or judges or whatever to clean up all the social ills that we have down here. Represents a challenge to them as well. And then we have our apparition of our lost loved ones that have died through OD, murder, unexplained death. And then we have our raven who had some part in the creation of the universe and a lot of legends. Shares and has knowledge of how the universe began. And now the raven shares this knowledge with a loved one who's passed on.
Consider myself an expert in totem pole making, but I'm just recalling what I saw my family do.
Thank you.
have a socket set or anything.
No, I left it at home.
Yeah. Go and check it. That spark plug out. See it.
This log here from Burrard Bend to Golden Hammer Park. I guess some guys had ordered a log for a canoe and they got the wrong log, so the bonus for us, because the artist wasn't happy with smaller logs.
This one's big
for what he wants to do, you know. Old growth red cedar, that's what he wanted, eh?
Yeah, well,
got a bit of a twist to it, but I don't think that'll be a problem for him.
On Monday, we worked on flattening off this bottom part of the tree so that we can square it off, make sure it's even all the way around. So once this is squared off, we turn it over and be able to put the figures on it. Then cut out the notches that need to be cut out. Because there's going to be a few places where there's going to be some cuts that on the pole. Sponsored by Carnegie and myself, I'm just a volunteer. But to me, I'm doing it because I like the tradition of art. And this totem pole is a memorial totem pole for people that have died down here, here in the east side. And I've had some relatives that have died here in Vancouver on the east side. So to me, by making this pole, it helps me grow as a person.
Yeah, at the top, all the meat. It has a lot of personal things attached to it. It is a memorial pole for the people who passed away down here, whether it be from ODs, murders, or unsolved cases. And I personally have lost family members down here to those particular headings, like murder and OD and missing persons. We got some missing person out there right now that nobody has a clue where they're at. And hopefully this totem pole will voice those concerns a lot more in terms of the public. These have to be brought forth. The whole question of the women getting murdered or OD being that could be curtailed through better health care or at least monitoring the people who have drug problems like they do have in Amsterdam or Switzerland. And the crime rate has dropped because of their system. And we'd like to see something similar or, you know, something that would curtail these deaths and help these people deal with their addictions. As far as I know, they're just out there by themselves and nobody's helping them. All they're doing is they're just being unrecognized, they're being ignored, and try to change it for the better. Basically, all these issues are arising from this one project, and it's doing a lot of good. Hopefully, people will come to realize that these problems are solvable, and we'll make it a better community for all of us to live in. Safer, cleaner, happier. Well, due to the rot, engineer said this is the, which was the bottom, is now the top, because there's no strength or something. They're worried about the strength, so the design might change altogether because of that. So we'll try to keep the theme of what we had before. So things are changing.
Yeah, pretty well. Today they're gonna move it, I guess.
Careful up there.
Okay.
We gotta do it more gradually.
Actually, it's a wheel problem again.
Yeah. We gotta do it more.
Yes, I can. Oh, ew.
Down!
Hey.
as long as it doesn't hit your bottom.
Well, you gotta wait.
Okay.
Got to
finger in.
Try.
All right.
Thank you.
three levels of government have to get together, and one of the things that we're pressing them to try and provide is this community with some detox and after detox, or you know, what's needed after detox, of course, is some form of treatment facility. And we think that for First Nations people, that treatment facility ought to take the shape of something that's culturally based. So
what's that? Gotta work on the food safe part of it.
No, I think this is beautiful.
Thank you.